What up, gamers? T.U.G here. This is episode 17 of the Ultimate Let's Play Breath of Fire. Last time, we explored Crypt and we got a new party member in the Thief Karn. And as I mentioned in the previous episode, we're going to be doing a little treasure hunting as opposed to advance the storyline on this episode. So first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to warp all the way back to Windling. Okay, so as soon as you warp, you're immediately placed in the dragon shrine of the town. So what I'm going to do here is, now that I have a way to open doors, if you recall, back in Windland Castle, there was a sealed-off treasure room that we can now access. And it was downstairs in the kitchen area. So we go around this, which will eventually take us out the eastern exit of Windland. We can now go in here for 6 treasure chests. A flame rapier, a cure, life 2, a turban, a broken sword, and a life. Now, a broken sword, do I have to repair that, or can I use it right now? I can use it right now. It does boost my attack, but I lose a lot of speed and magic defense. And then, what about these? I can use the turban. The flame rapier's for Nina, so now she got a nice power boost. Albeit, it's probably not going to be that much of a noticeable difference. Got a lot of helmets that I can use. I think I'll leave everything else as is. Okay. So I think we're done here. Now I have to exit out of the town in order to use warp. Okay, so looking through my notes here. We're next going to warp to Romero. Okay. And what I'm planning on doing here is actually heading back to Agua Tower. Because there were some locked treasures there as well. And I also believe there's a couple hidden rooms in there that now we can access. So we still have the tablet on hand. We'll go ahead and use that to bring Agua Tower to us. Okay, let's head inside. Okay, let's put Karn in the front of the party here. Those treasures I still cannot get, but now I have a little bit of a shortcut all the way to the top. Okay. Well, we might as well have some battles. I mean, Karn's still, I would like to have it leveled up once. I'm not sure how far away he is from leveling up. But yeah, now that I have Karn, I can go this way, which we didn't have access to earlier. We're out to this section. Grab this chest here for a lava shield. Who would best benefit from the lava shield? That's actually a huge boost. I'm going to give it to me. I should say Ryu. Give the metal shield to Karn. Boost his defense a little bit. Is there anything more? So I'd either take a lift ride or go up the stairs. I'll go up the stairs. This looks new. Almost looks like a dragon shrine. There's really nothing in here, though. The machine has a place for a key. Unfortunately, none of the keys I have are useful in it. So let me go ahead and check each of these towers. I mean, there's gotta be something here. As a matter of fact, I read that there's supposed to be something absolutely phenomenal here, so Just a matter of where the heck do I find it? See, a lot of spots for keys. I'm guessing these are the spots for the six goddess keys. However, I do not have all of them at this time. I guess I go up. The hell is this? Spot for a teleporter, but it's not working. Guess we'll be coming back here later. I'm wondering if I was even supposed to be able to reach this area yet. Let's check these statues here. Life armor, okay. How about this one? And an icy dagger, I think? So let's see what this life armor does. Damn, that is a monster gain in defense. That's 85 points. My defense is already at 241. And the icy dagger is going to boost Karn's... Oh, wow, this is amazing. 43-point boost in Karn's attack. So, he's now going to be a huge offensive threat. Yeah, I'm beginning to believe I wasn't supposed to come here until much later in the game. I mean, I knew there was some good stuff here, and, wow, but that's just amazing. So, both Ryu and Karn just got a massive boost in their strength, so this very well may, significantly reduce the amount of grinding I have to do. Again, I'm still at no grinding at all for this, project, so I've been very fortunate. Now my chances of having to grind have gone down significantly. Okay, look at the red notes here. Anything else I need to do? Well, let's see here. Well, might as well release some baggage here. Don't need that anymore. So I can make a little bit of money here. That's Karn's old dagger. Get rid of that. Lose that. Okay, I'm up to 26,000 gold now. Yeah, I'm just looking through my notes here, and I think that's really all I can get at this point. A lot more of this stuff is not until later in the game that I'm looking at, so I won't spoil it for you right now. But I think at this point, yeah, if I try to do more of the storyline at this point, it's going to really extend my video a long time. So I'm just going to go ahead and warp back to Bleak, and I think I'm going to go ahead and call it quits. I know it's going to be a short video, but I don't want my videos to be too long, so I'll go ahead and continue the story on in the next episode. Until next time, this is T.U.G saying be smart, be safe, have fun. Later, gamers.